Hello.
Hello.
This instrument is called TAR, T-A-R. It's predecessor of all the instruments which have T-A-R at the end, like guitar, sitar. So this is a Persian instrument which goes back to probably 900,000 years ago. And this is like a violin, but you put it on your lap and it's called kemanche. Kemanche, and this is a Persian name, but I talk about it when I play for you, ney and kemanche. But this is tar. And it has animal skin, this is sheep skin. And these are all guts. The same as this one. So that's a natural animal skin. And this is why they are very sensitive to temperature. So if it's humid, if they go loose and lose the tuning, so you've got to retune it again. Thank you. instrument is a ney. It's a Persian ney, which is really hard to learn because it's got a big hole, so there is no reed. You have to put it between your front teeth, so you've got to be able to drive it between your front teeth. If you don't have a gap, because there is a metal tip like this tip here on top, so you have to have a gap between your front teeth, otherwise you wouldn't be able to play this instrument. But because I didn't have the gap, actually I tried it. I went to the dentist and I asked for a sander or whatever to sand it and to make a gap. But they couldn't do anything about it. So I put plastic so I can drive it between my front teeth. Okay. This is Kamanche, K-A-M-A-N-C-H-E, or H at the end, because we said Kamanche, it's H at the end. This is very old as well, mother of violin, or father of violin. Sheepskin, walnut, and walnut again.
Thank you.
have to dance very much. Okay. I can play. This is not like violin. I mean, the bow doesn't go like violin. So you've got to turn the instruments by itself. And it's got a round neck, as you can see. It's not flat. So the bow goes like this, and the instruments turn around to get the right strings. That's a Persian scale called shur.